Hi, I'm Philip Muggleston from the HANA Academy. In the next set of videos, we're going to look at how you can access the predictive analytic capabilities of HANA when you're using the HANA Express Edition. One of the really important capabilities of HANA is predictive analytics, and this is built into the in-memory engine of HANA through something called the Predictive Analysis Library. Now, when you're working with the HANA Express Edition, of course you want to take advantage of this. And if we look actually on the main website for HANA Express, we can see that predictive analytics is one of the major talking points and sections. We've got a lot of different algorithms in the predictive analysis library that we can use. However, this does require some additional configuration of the base HANA Express server. And that's what we're going to see in this video, how we can do that initial getting started basic configuration. Now, I'm going to assume that you've already got a HANA Express VMware image up and running. I'm working with the server-only version. You see that I've actually started a brand new one here. I've logged in, changed the password, and I've checked the IP address, which then I can put into my hosts file as a HXE host. Do that on my desktop. That way I can access it through a host name rather than the IP address directly. So that initial setup has all been done. What we then want to do is make sure that you've already got Eclipse up and running, because you're going to need Eclipse for this. Again, you'll see that in one of Julie's videos in the same playlist here on the Academy, how to go through the process of setting up and configuring Eclipse. I haven't actually logged in yet, but that's something we're going to do shortly. So we're going to need to work with Eclipse, and we're going to need to make sure that the HANA tools have been installed with Eclipse. So you'll see other videos that give details on doing that. So the first thing we need to do is to log in to our system. So to do that from Eclipse, I'm going to go to Add System. I'm going to specify HXE host because that is my host name, and the instance is 00. And this is a multi-database container system, so we need to select multiple containers. And initially, you just have a system database. So we're going to connect to that system database, and we'll do that using the system user. And the default password, if you've not changed it yet, is HXE HANA1. So let's log in with that user. And if you've not logged in before, when you click finish, it will prompt you to change your password. So let's put in the old one, and then another one, which of course is a nice secured password. So now we've logged in, changed our password for the system user. So we can see we can access the system DB. Now the first thing you'd want to do there is just go and select it and choose the little administration icon. We're going to just check that the Application Function Library, or AFL, which is where the predictive capabilities are stored, has been installed. And you can see, yes, in the installed plugins, it's got AFL. And if you want, you can actually click on there to get much more details about it. If you find that you don't have the AFL installed, it's possible you've downloaded an older version. So go back to the download manager of HANA Express and get an up-to-date version. And then you should find that AFL is installed for you. So what we need to do now is actually configure that the predictive analysis library is usable. Now the predictive analysis library uses something called the script server. And this is something we're going to need to enable because it's not enabled out of the box. Now, when you're working with the script server, it's only going to work and the predictive capabilities only work in a proper tenant database. We're currently connected to the system database, which is just for really system administration. So what we're going to need to do is to create a tenant database and then activate the script server within that. So rather than writing all the code from scratch, what you can do is go to the HANA Academy. And you'll find that in our playlist, there'll be a link. And that link will take you to a GitHub repository. And in fact, if you want to find it, you can always just go to github.com/HANA Academy, look in the list of repositories, and you'll find this one called HXE for HANA Express Edition. And in there, we've got some code and test data, etc., etc. So what you want to do in this case is open up the predictive PAL AFM getting started. It's a SQL file. And then what you can also do is maybe go into raw option. And that makes it very easy that you can then copy and paste it. So I'm going to just Control All and Control C on my Windows desktop to copy that code. And what I want to do now is to go back to Eclipse. And in Eclipse, as the system user, I'm going to open up a SQL console. And now I'm going to use Control V to paste in that code. Now don't get trigger happy and just go and run this code straight away. There's actually a number of things you have to do that have been condensed into this single script. Now the first thing that as the system user against our system database, the first thing we're going to do is just do a double check that the predictive analysis libraries are up and running and available. So if we just execute this select statement, we'll see from the sys schema we've got a list of the functions that are there. For example, ARIMA, forecast, etc. Auto ARIMA is new with SPS 12, so that's looking good that we have the functions installed. If you get nothing back here, then it means that probably the AFL has not been installed. The second thing is we're going to create ourselves a new tenant database. We're going to do that using create database syntax. The name of my tenant database is SHA for SAP HANA Academy. Of course, you can use any three-letter code you want for your tenant database. And then we're going to set it up with a system user and we can put in a default password. Of course, you would set that to be a very nice secure password. You would never use password one in the real world. So let's go ahead and create our tenant database. Now this will take a few seconds. So we can see that's now finished and we've got the create database successfully executed. It actually took 1.5 minutes on my Windows desktop. So yeah, just be patient with that. Go and make a coffee if you want during that process. Now we've created our tenant database, the next thing is we need to enable the script server on that tenant database. So for this, we'll use the alter database syntax for the SHA tenant database, and we're going to add the script server. So again, we'll run that particular line 10, that piece of syntax. Again, this may take a few seconds. So we can see that the alter database has completed successfully. Again, it may take a few seconds. In my case, it took about a minute. Now we've done that, we're ready to actually log on and access our tenant database. So you'll notice in the code it does say now on line 14, run as the system user against the tenant database. So what we need to do is make a new connection where we're going to connect this time again to the same HXC host and the instance 00, multiple containers, but this time we're going to connect to our tenant database. So put in the three characters that you used, in my case SHA, log in with that system user, and it's the password that you specified in the code we just ran. So in my case, it was password one, and we'll store it, hit finish, and we should now be able to log in as the system user for that tenant database. So we can see we're logged in to the SHA database now as the system user. What we can then do is change our connection in this SQL console so that we're connected not as the system user on systemdb, but with a system user on the SHA, so your tenant database. And now we're ready to run the code that starts around line 14. Here, we're going to actually create a user that we'll use for development with the necessary authorizations to work with the predictive capabilities. Because, of course, HANA's locked down out of the box, so you do need to open up the capabilities to work with the predictive libraries. So the first thing, we'll create a user called DevUser. We're then going to authorize the creation and removal of procedures using the predictive analysis library to that user. We're going to authorize execution of procedures that you've created to the user as well, that you might do to end users at some point. We're going to enable modeling. We're going to enable HANA native development. This is so we can use something called the AFM or the Application Function Modeler to actually generate code for us. We'll see that in a future video. And then we're basically ready to go. So let's go ahead and run that code just as far as the enable native development. And we can see it's done now run and that user's created. Now, if you want to run some examples, we've got some sample data in a schema. And the easiest way to get hold of that is to go again to GitHub. In this case, what you'd want to do is go to the predictive analysis library repository. So for that one, actually, if you just click on the HANA Academy, you'll find that the PAL, the Predictive Analysis Library repository, is in there. And if you scroll down, you'll see there is a source data folder. And in the source data, there's a PAL schema.zip. What you should do is click on that to download or click on it, and then choose the download option, and then unzip that locally on your desktop. Once you've done that, go back into Eclipse, use the file and the import option, and you need to then go to HANA catalog options, And there, make sure you're connecting as the system user for your SHA tenant database, because we're going to install it onto that database. And then you would point to where locally you have downloaded and unzipped the file I just showed you on GitHub. And then you should get a list of different tables. So basically select them all. You should go basically from calendar to stocks. I'm going to add them, hit next, hit next again. And it's now going to run a little job to import that data into your database. So now if we look at the system, go to catalog, we see there's a PAL schema. And if we go to the tables, we should find some tables, one of which, for example, is called customers. And if I just choose to preview, just check that we can see the data in there. So yes, we've managed to get some sample test data that we'll be able to use later. What we also now need to do, however, is grant access to this schema, this one we've created called PAL, to the developer user that's going to be working. And also we need to grant access to it to the system repo, which is actually the repository of HANA. This is when we're going to be working with the AFM, Application Function Modeler. So let's run these two lines of code. Of course, you cannot run this until you've imported your schema. If you have your own data, then of course, just change the schema name here to whatever suits you. So that's now run. So we're looking good. We've now authorized the developer user. What we now need to do is to log on as our developer user so we can run the final bit of script as that developer user. So for that, we can select the system connection to our tenant database, right mouse button, and we can say add system with different user. And this name, we're just going to put in dev user with its initial password. And we're going to, of course, need to change it the first time. And we can put a nice secure password in. So the user has had his password changed. We're now logged in as the developer user. So now we can go to the right-hand side, choose connection. We can change the connection to the developer user against our tenant database. And now we can run the last line of code. And what this basically does is it grants authorization to the technical user of the HANA database repository so that he can access your developer schema. And again, this is something you're going to need if you want to work with the AFM later on. So I'm going to run that final piece of code. So now we've been through the process of configuring the predictive analysis library and also the AFM when we want to work with HANA Express, because it's not something you can do when you're working with a standard system database. You need to make sure you create your own tenant database and that you also enable the script server in that tenant database. And in fact, we can just verify that if we go to that, for example, as our system administrator user on your tenant database, hit the administration button. The dev user wouldn't have the rights really to do this. So we can see the overview, but if you click the landscape tab, what you will see is that we've got the script server and it's green, it's up and running. So that's something you'll need when you're working with the PAL. So in this video, we've seen how to configure your environment so that you can start working with the predictive analysis library. In the next videos, we're going to see how we can use either SQL script or we can use the AFM, the Application Function Modeler, to actually work with the predictive analysis library.